She wasn't at the wheel, not even at the scene. But prosecutors say the woman who owns this car sold alcohol to the teenager who died. And she faces a felony charge. Good evening, I'm Rob McCartney.
I'm Brandi Peterson. 20-year-old Amanda Hyman could serve 5 years in jail if convicted. She's charged in the crash that killed Jacob Dickmeyer and injured Colby Burke. Dickmeyer lost control near 204th and Dodge last week.
In tonight's big story, we're taking a closer look at the arrest warrant, and we're hearing from a teenager who was among the last to see Dickmeyer before he died. KETV Newswatch 7's Natalie Glucklich is live. Natalie?
Rob, A.J. Nichols says he dropped Dickmeyer and Burke off at the Fire Barn Bar and Grill in Waterloo a week ago Sunday, then went home because he had to work in the morning. Now Nichols says he wishes he had stayed and wishes Hyman would have driven his friends home that night, like he says she promised. This is how it ended, but A.J. Nichols says the Sunday with his buddies started like this.
We were going around to look at Christmas lights and the houses that light up with the music.
Nichols says he dropped off 18-year-old Jacob Dickmeyer and 19-year-old Colby Burke here. He says Dickmeyer's friend, 20-year-old Amanda Hyman, was a server at the Fire Barn Bar and Grill in Waterloo, and that his friends were planning to drink.
I had thought that Amanda was going to drive them home. That's the whole reason that I left.
But according to these court documents, Hyman admitted to giving Dickmeyer the keys to her car. And before that, Dickmeyer and Burke ordered 2 pitchers of beer, 4 Jaeger bombs, and 2 Long Island iced teas. Burke told investigators Hyman served them.
You can see the consequences. There's an individual who's dead, and now there's a person that's going to be charged with a felony because of that.
Nichols says he never knew where Dickmeyer and Burke were going in Hyman's car that night, only that the crash that killed Dickmeyer and hurt Burke should never have happened.
To me, Dickmeyer didn't make a decision to get in that car. He didn't know what he was doing. He was really drunk.
Nichols says there were several bad decisions made that night, leaving only regret in the nights that followed.
It makes me really upset that all these things could have been done differently, and not one of them was done differently.
And we spoke with a co-owner of the bar today who called Hyman a rogue employee that no longer works there. The warrant shows Dickmeyer went to the bar earlier that night with a different friend that another server sold him a soda. We went to Amanda Hyman's house in Fremont tonight. No one answered the door. She's expected to surrender tomorrow and could get 5 years in prison if convicted. Brandi, back to you.
Thanks.